in 1942, I had what I thought was thoroughly refuted the frequency of sympatric speciation. In fact, I said, even though it is possible, there really aren't any good cases. Well, in the 20 years or 25 years after my book, various entomologists again began to promote the idea of frequency of sympatric speciation. Well, I had in 1947, a detailed analysis of what is needed in order for sympatric speciation to be successful. And what I said at that time was still valid at that time, but eventually more and more people talked about sympatric speciation, and it is now a wide open question, particularly since an entire new group of organisms has been found that seems to have frequent sympatric speciation, and that is freshwater fishes. And there are numerous people working on this now, papers appearing every year, several papers in a thing, so that I have to simply say that even though I had never questioned the possibility of sympatric speciation, the actual demonstration of it, which had not yet been done in 1942, is beginning to come very close to being done.